Hello, welcome to another VB script video, and in this video we'll understand procedures. So what is a procedure? Well, a procedure in VB script is some reusable code. So instead of writing the same kind of script code again and again, we can write a procedure and we can call it as many number of times as we want from our main script or driver script. There are two kinds of procedures in VB script: sub procedure and function procedure. So what are the advantages of using a procedure? The big advantage of using a procedure is that it saves us time in scripting. So instead of repeating the same code within our script at a number of places, we can create a procedure and place the code within that. And whenever we want to execute that code, we just have to call that procedure. The second big advantage of using procedure is that it saves us testing time. So instead of debugging a big script, we can place the reusable code within the procedure and test the procedure thoroughly. Once the procedure is tested, we have better confidence in the procedure and we can call the procedure as many number of times as we want with confidence. Another advantage of using procedures is modularity. So it makes the code modular. The common code is put out in the form of procedures and we can call them, so it makes the script more readable. So we are going to have the main script or the driver script, which basically has calls to different procedures, and it makes it better to understand the procedure. So let us first see what is a sub procedure. A sub procedure in VB script starts with the sub statement followed by the name of the procedure, and it ends with the end sub statement. A sub procedure may or may not take arguments. Arguments are the additional information you give when you call the procedure. The sub procedure can be called with or without using the call statement. There are a couple of ways in which we can call the sub procedure, and we'll see those shortly. The main thing about the sub procedure is that it does not provide any return value. So it is more or less self-contained. So everything that needs to happen happens within the sub procedure. So now we are going to see an example of procedures, both the sub procedure and the function procedure, and here is the flowchart for the script. So we want to convert kilograms to pounds. So first of all, the user enters the weight in kilograms, and then there is a call to the procedure, and the name of the procedure is convert weight. So convert weight requires an argument, which is what is the number of kilos we want to convert to pounds. And then there is a call to another procedure, end script, which basically does some messaging to the user, and then it stops. So let us see an example of a sub procedure that converts kilograms to pounds. So here is the example, and what I have selected over here is the main script or the driver script. So let us go through it line by line to understand it. So first is the option explicit statement, which we have already covered in the last video. Then we declare a variable called input weight, and we say input weight is equal to, and we use the built-in VB script function input box, and input box is going to give the prompt as enter the weight in kilos and convert it to a double. C double is the built-in VB script function to convert a number to a double with decimal points and with precision, and that value gets stored in input weight. Now the next line contains a call to the convert weight sub procedure. So let us go to the convert weight sub procedure. So here it is, from line number 9 to line number 15, and it accepts a single argument, which is called kilos within the procedure. So here we declare another variable dim pounds, and we write the conversion formula. Pounds is equal to 2.205 into kilos. So whatever value was given to it as the argument is multiplied by 2.205, and then it prints it out in the form of a message box. Then the control goes back to the main script or the driver script, and then on line 6 there is a call to another procedure, and here it is the end script procedure that is being called. An end script basically puts out a message box for thanking the user for using our script. So let us execute this script and see how it works. So The name of the script is kilos pounds sub.vbs, so we can execute it within the command prompt window. And here we are getting the input box on line number 3 in our script. So enter the weight in kilos. So let us say I give a value of 1 and click on the OK button. So it is going to call the convert weight sub procedure, and that is going to show the message box, the weight is so much. And here we get the message box. This message box is coming from line number 12, which is within the convert weight sub procedure. And it says the weight of 1 kg is equivalent to 2.205 pounds. And we click on OK. Then here the end script procedure is being called, and it just says thank you for using our script. So this is the sub procedure. As you can see that we have called our sub procedure in a cup once by using an argument. So here on line number 4 we gave the argument the input weight, which is the weight entered by the user. And once we have called another sub procedure without using any argument, because this does not need additional information to be passed on to the sub procedure. Now there are a couple of different ways of calling the sub procedure. One is obviously by using the call statement. So we give call name of the sub procedure, and then we give the arguments within parentheses. We can do the same thing by not using the call statement. So we just give the name of the procedure, and the list of arguments, if we have one or more, is given as a comma separated list. And this is exactly the same thing. So let us run it one more time. So enter the weight in kilos. So this time I'm going to put as 2, and it says the weight of 2 kg is equivalent to 4.41 pounds. So these are a couple of ways of calling the sub procedure. One important thing to keep in mind is that we may call the convert weight sub procedure that we have written once. We can call it as many number of times as we want in our main script or driver script. Another advantage is that if you have to make a change, let us say that you want more precision, instead of putting 2.205 as a conversion factor, you want to give a bigger conversion factor which is more scientific, so you can give 2.2046 something, and you just have to make the change at one place, that is within the sub procedure. You don't have to make the change at any other place. So let us go back and see what is a function procedure now, which is the second kind of procedure in VBScript. So a function procedure starts with the function statement followed by the name of the procedure, and it ends with the end function statement. As with sub procedure, it may or may not take arguments. And the difference between sub procedure and function procedure is that function procedure can provide a return value. So basically, just as we can use the built-in functions of VBScript, we can create our own function procedures, and we can use them just as we use the built-in functions of VBScript. Now, since the function can provide a return value, it can be called within a statement. So let us see the example of this. So here we have the same conversion, kilos to pounds, but this time instead of implementing it as a sub procedure, I've implemented it as a function procedure. So the main script or the driver script or model is the same. So there is a variable input weight, and it takes the user input and converts it to a double and stores it in the input weight. And then there is a message box statement, and message box statement directly calls the function procedure by putting the name of the procedure and the argument. So when it does that, the control goes to the function procedure, which is from line 9 to line 12. And here it takes the argument kilos, and you can notice that it multiplies 2.205 into kilos and puts that in the name of the function. So wherever this function is called, the value of 2.205 into the argument is going to be replaced. So let us execute this and see how it works. So now we have kilos pounds function dot VBS, and I'm going to enter the same weight in kilos, 1, and you can see the weight of 1 kg is equivalent to 2.205 pounds. So we get the same thing, but here instead of using a sub procedure, we have used a function procedure. And we click on OK. And last time we had the subroutine exit message, but this time we are calling the function. So exit message just returns a message, and which is in turn used by the message box statement. So it says thank you for using our script. So here we can see that the function procedure starts with the function statement and it ends with the end function statement, and in between it provides the return value. The return value is provided wherever we put the name of the function is equal to something. And there are couple of ways in which arguments can be passed. So we can see the pounds function accepts an argument of kilos, whereas the exit message function does not accept any argument. So it is possible to provide arguments to a function, or if you don't want to give arguments to a function, it is possible to write functions in VBScript without providing any arguments also. So I hope you were able to understand the procedures in VBScript. The two kinds of procedures in VBScript are the sub procedure and the function procedure. The advantages of using procedures are that they save us time in scripting. So we can just write down the procedure once, and we can call it as many times as we want from our main script or driver script, and we can test it out separately. And once we test out the procedure separately, we have better confidence in the procedure, and we can use it with confidence by using the call statement in the case of sub procedure, or directly putting the name of the function procedure in the case of function procedure. And both sub procedure and function procedure can be written with or without the arguments. So I hope this was useful to you in understanding VBScript procedures, and thank you, and see you in the next video.